Hello, and thank you so much for joining me today. My name is Sasha Reed, and I've got an extra bonus video for you this week. I have had a little bit of extra spare time, so I thought let's have a midweek video. We haven't had one of those in forever. Now, I don't know if you've got Nuvo drops or the scrapbook.com sort of equivalent or any of these kind of drops, stickles, those sorts of things, but these have been staring me in the face and I keep looking at them thinking, I must use them, I must use them. And they've been on my desk for ages. I've had most of these for well over 2 years, some of them pushing 4 years, I think. And I just thought, right, they're sitting there doing nothing. We need to make use of them. We need to find a way to play with them and kind of get rid of them. I would love to get more colors, but I can't justify it because I have all these colors and I'm not using them. Now I thought, let's play with them. Let's use them in a different way than what they were intended. They're used for making drops, adding embellishments onto your card. They maintain their dimension and character. But today we are just going to squish them. We're just going to squish them all over our paper and play with them. I've seen this all over social media. People are using various paints, I think acrylic paints or oil paints, and they're doing this kind of dragging technique. Now, my daughter's birthday was last week, and I had to get one of those cake funnel things to put icing on cakes, and it came with like a whole kit and had these things in there. So I thought, I'll grab that. That will work for smudging this down the paper. Anything flat will work, but I am just taking some Nuvo drops and I'm literally just having a play here. There's nothing complex or overly exciting about what I'm doing. I am just sticking them onto my paper and smushing them down, sometimes wiggling my little flat thingy across the paper to see if I can get a different kind of pattern. And just having to play. And then I just decided I wanted some more color. I wanted the color to really last and get all the way to the bottom. So I decided to put dots and see what that would look like. Honestly, just have a play. And I used so much of this stuff. Like, I mean, I did about, I think, 20 panels in the end, and I still have tons of my Nuvo drops left. I didn't even really make a dent in them. I think my lowest one has got almost half, but not quite half. So you can really stretch these. I didn't realize how much was in these tubes, but I did do a lot of panels and I did go quite heavy with it, and I still have quite a lot left. So if you haven't got Nuvo drops or any kind of stickles or glittery drop things like this, then by all means get out some acrylic paint and have a go with that and see how it goes. But some of these ones, like this one here, are my favorite, where I've used the glitter ones and the shine and the sheen is amazing. I also have some of these pearlescent ones, so I'm using them as well. So the metallic ones were my favorite. And I used all kinds of Nuvo drops. I've got a couple of them are like the sort of chunky, coarse ones that are meant to look like stone. Some are glitter, some are pearlescent, some are clear, some are opaque. I found the clear ones didn't really work. I didn't really like how the clear ones worked for me. Like these ones here, they look great, but when you put them on black, they're all right. But I have some of them, like a blue one was just super see-through and it didn't really work for me. So these are all the panels I did. I still have tons of Nuvo drops left over in the end. Obviously, if you're making one card, pick your favorite colors and go for it. This is one of the ones where I've mixed the stone one in with like a translucent blue and it's got such amazing texture. So while I'm showing you these, I am pulling out my favorite ones to the left, which I want to make some cards out of, and then the ones that are all right to the right, which I could die cut out of and use them in the future. So there I was just showing you the two glitter ones, one on black and one on white, and the difference. So here's the black and the white with the same colors again. It's just a matter of preference, whatever you like. This one here is probably my favorite one of all of them. It looks a hot mess, but the card I make with it is gorgeous. So get out your supplies, have a go, see what you can make. If you use some acrylic paints, then I bet you'll have a very similar effect. Now I wanted to make some embellishments to go on the front of my cards. I want the star of the show to be the backgrounds I just made. So I'm going to use these flower stencils. They come with a coordinating embossing folder, which also has a die that can cut it out as well. So I'm going to whiz through this process because the star of the show is the fun background we just did, but I didn't want you to watch this and then have no clue what I was doing and how I got that flower. So I've got these stencil brushes here, which I bought as a 50 pack from AliExpress. I kid you not, it cost me about £12 for 50 of these stencil brushes. And they are meant to do makeup. They're like little eyeshadow brushes or something, but they are my favorite go-to kind of brush. They're nice and flat. They work so well for doing stencils, and I never have an issue with them. And now I've got one for every color, so I am well thrilled. I'll put that link down below for you if you want to check it out. I'll put all the links to all the products I use as well down in the description box. So if you want to have a look at any of these things and check them out, you can. Now, these new metallic inks from Lisa Horton are unreal. You'll see them towards the end when I kind of shift the card a bit. They are so stunning. They are so shiny and gorgeous. And they're my new obsession, so you're probably going to see them in most videos because they are so stunning to add as accents on. So you can see the middle of my flower there is done with that metallic ink. So I've gone ahead and I've embossed using the embossing folder that came with these stencils, and I've die cut out the flower as well. And I've cut myself a nice little frame. These frame dies are from Craftelier in Europe. They're located in Spain. And they're such awesome little frames. They've got like a cute little detail to them, but they cut just the frame. So there's no layering up your dies and faffing about with trying to make a frame yourself, which you could do if you have layering dies. But I like this because I can just quickly Bosch them out with my Big Shot and they're already pre-ready to go as a frame. Now I decided here that I wanted to slot my flowers into my frame so they kind of have a continuous look. So I'm leaving a tiny little gap along the bottom edge of that panel die, or sorry, die cut, so that when I go ahead and stick on the next layer, so I'm doing four layers here to make it nice and chunky, I'm leaving that gap in between the second and third layer of die cutting. So now I've got my nice chunky solid frame with my little gap. So I'm just checking and making sure I've got that gap there. And then I'll label it as well because I'm notorious for forgetting which bit is the bit that I wanted to save. I'm putting quite a lot of glue on. I know I'm putting lots of glue on. I'm doing it quite thin, but my cardstock is a little bit warpy from using my Nuvo drops. And I did leave these to dry overnight just to let you know. They will dry within probably an hour or two, but I did leave them overnight and came back to it the next day just because I had lots of stuff on and was busy. So I ended up leaving them overnight. So I'm going to stick my frame right down on that panel. And then I'm going to go ahead and tuck my little flowers in. Now, I was making a bit of a mental note when I was tucking these in as to where I needed to put foam squares and where I needed to put glue. Because obviously my frame is nice and popped up high, but my flowers will sit flat against that glittery background unless I put some foam to kind of match the height of the frame around my card. So I'm just kind of drawing with a pencil where I don't want to put any foam dots just to make sure I remember. And then I can go ahead and add some dimension onto the back of that flower and stick them onto my card with a little bit of glue on the edges that are going to touch my little frame. So I've got that one done for now. And to kind of give it a bit more pizzazz, I'm using this glittery pink. I felt like it needed a little bit more dimension and a bit more shine. And then this pink kind of tied it into the background even more because the background was made using this glittery pink. Now moving on to card number two, and I will come back to the first one and show you how it's all finished off when it's all dry. I went ahead and used some more of these fun metallic inks. So I have got the black one and the green one. And the idea behind these is that they change colors. So the black one changes to orange when you put it on black cardstock, and the green changes to blue on black cardstock. For my top layer of this stencil, I decided to use my Nuvo drops instead of using the inks. And that's why you've got the gorgeous sort of shiny, glittery, beautiful finish to that rose. And I didn't go for a traditional colored rose, but I wanted my rose to tie in with my background because this is my favorite background that I created today. And I wanted the colors to kind of coordinate with that background and not stand off of it and add more color to it. So I went with sort of a bluish rose, a bluey green rose rather than a pink one. But I love how this card turned out. I think it's absolutely gorgeous. And then there's one more that I was desperate to finish, but I kind of ran out of time. And I wanted to get this video up for you so you could have an extra video. But this is a stamp set and die set I'm hoping to use to finish off this one. I felt like this background kind of had a Christmassy feel to it. So I was thinking of using these baubles and these dies. Let me know in the comments what you think I should do with that blue background. But I think it would make a really pretty Christmas card. So to finish off this card here, I used this stamp set from My Favorite Things and I stamped on a sentiment using my beautiful shiny ink. And then I used a die set that I've got that I don't even have the coordinating stamps to go with. I don't even know if there's coordinating stamps or not, but I love this die set. I've got it in three different sizes. It's just really handy dandy. It has kind of all the sizes and shapes that you might need for a sentiment to go onto your card. And then finishing off the first card I created with you, I used my favorite stamps and dies from Trinity Stamps. And I did message them and ask them if they've got Christmas ones coming out because honestly, I use these 24/7 and they did get back to me and said that they are on their way to scrapbook.com. So I'm so excited. I can't wait to buy them once they're available. I have no idea what they're going to look like, but I love the happy and the birthday and the you and the thank you so much that I'm going to get my hands on those other ones for Christmas for sure. So here are my finished cards. I hope you had a really fun time with me, and I hope to see you on Saturday night for some Saturday night crafting as well. I don't know what I'm doing yet, but I'm going to be working on it. And if you haven't heard already, don't forget to join the Stress-Free Card Making Summit. I have got the chance to create with 29 other amazing crafters, and the summit goes live next weekend, so not this weekend, coming up next weekend. And if you want to, there is an option to purchase the bundle so that you can watch it anytime you like and get all access pass to all the extra bonus stuff as well. The link for your free ticket is down in the description box, so just click that link and then it will take you through to get your free ticket. Take care, and I'll see you on Saturday. Bye.